Alright. We got the ghost armor. It's fully upgraded. We got that new Mongol commander's armor yesterday. Looks pretty dope. Let's do this. Let's do this.
We could use the old road from Omi up through Fort Kaminodake. Only problem is it's held by Mongols. You need help to drive them out. I know some hunters camped on Mount Sago. Their leader's named Takashi.
Friend of yours?
No, but he'll do anything I ask, and his men are good archers. While you're meeting them, I'll slip through your uncle's castle. Meet our friends in Omi.
Lead them to strike the fort from the south. I'll attack from the north, with your hunter friends.
You think it'll work?
Yes. Be careful, you know.
You too.
Textures? ...1.9 kilometers. Magni! Why don't you just pull that cable off the desk? You little shit. Little shit! I kinda wanna go see these question marks. Ghost of Distractions. What this game should be. Because he's rude. Magni is rude. Someone hurt the great Deku tree, it's totes true. And they will pay. Ooh, girl. We got a new sword kit. Ooh, girl. Sword kit! This one's flames. Hi, pupper. Oh, pupper. Yay, we got a bamboo cut. Good boy. Excuse me? For it to do its thing. Can I cross the river? Without being brutally murdered? Moided? Brutally moided? Yeah, Gina, I thought 2020 was going to be a shit year for video games, but I'm really excited for a lot of different stuff. Excited to get back to the Master Chief Collection. Excited to finish up Assassin's Creed Odyssey so that we can get hyped for Valhalla. I want to do a ton of D&D streams this year. Got a lot. I really want to start pouring time into the D&D world. Ugh. This be a fox den up here.
To foxy lady.
Or boy, I don't know. I sure hope the next PlayStation's controller is much more comfortable. Two things that happened. So, like, right back here, where the trigger, right here, this piece of plastic, not the trigger itself, but this little piece of, like, trim that the plastic, like, that the trigger goes into, the way that I hold the controller is like this. Like that. And, I really press into that hard plastic back there, and it just hurts like hell. You got a problem? Wait. Okay, I'm coming. There goes splat. So I'm hoping the PS5 controller doesn't have that issue. Because it's like a saw blade. And it just hurts like the dickens. To that box. Missing. I feel like in general this game faces you the right direction after fast traveling, which is very cool. Nice touch. This does say the bamboo is full. There, that's an official 500 bamboo. Can't carry anymore. Hot springs. Samurai booty. I tell you what, being in a really cold environment in a hot spring. Oh, it's something special.
You could have been here right now, Rizal. Bragging about how many Mongol heads you collected. Telling your awful jokes. You gave me no choice.
But you had to be a little bitch.
haven't even been here before. Wouldn't it be cool if your fast travel actually, like, discovered stuff too? What if I fast traveled from here to here and it just drew a line? That'd be neato. All right, okay. We're looking pretty badass. Look like Raiden.
Liu Kang, we must defeat Shang Tsung.
Ivory of Woe? Just laying there? Oh, that's cute. That's cute. I like it.
Greetings.
Alright. We're not gonna talk about what happened here. It's best if I just leave it alone.
Yeah.
Look at all this burned forest. Yawaguai. Feel like this one's gonna be another Foxton. But we'll see. No, it's another samurai booty.
Release the booty.
What's up, I remember. Yeah, we're playing Batman Samurai.
I didn't know you long, but you were brave, Taka.
Stupid.
As brave as any samurai I've met.
But brave.
I hope you knew that.
Booty!
Okay, so... what's this quest? This quest out here. I'm excited to sit down and start working on the D&D campaign again now. Now that I have my focus reset, I was falling into a too much detail rut. Was gonna start with like creation stories and stuff like that. Too much, you don't need all that. What's up, rental horse? Controller vibrating. Don't mind me. Yeah, I do got a pretty good foundation, don't I? I think it's a good leaping off point. Yeah, I'm gonna flush all that out. I think I'm gonna get like the cultures and the thing was is I was like, okay, I'm gonna go through and fix up the human kingdoms, give them a little bit more life, because one of the first criticisms that I got was, except for the capital, like every town mentally looked exactly the same and there was no differences and no character. It was just like the same town layout over and over and over and over. So I was like, okay, time to add some characters. And I was like working on the human kingdoms and I'm like, wait a minute. Dwarves and elves are not as common as humans, but they're common enough to have, like, whole kingdoms and stuff, and, like, I'm not giving them the light of day.
Why did it have to be you?
Then I got into, like, fleshing that out, and we did some seriously good work on that, on our homebrew stream. And then I was like, oh, we need to get into where the elves came from and where the dwarves came from. And now I'm writing like Bible for the fucking elves and dwarves and it's just gotten out of control. I just need to dial back a little bit. I need to decide what races. I think I want all player races to have a little bit of culture. Like, even if like the Dragonborn and the Orcs have just a little bit of culture, because you can play in half orc and stuff like that. It's bamboo. Now let's talk to this dude.
What happened here?
The Mongols found out my sons burned one of their supply wagons. They forced me to choose which son they'd kill as punishment.
Oh. I'm sorry. What happened to your other son?
They took him. I'm sure it was Chuta's idea to burn their supplies.
He may still be alive. Which way did they go?
Across the bridge.
All right. Let's go give him some fun. Warforged have a story. They got a background. They're good. Goliaths are gonna have one. I haven't fleshed out the Goliaths yet, but I did for them. And it's like, do I want... I guess it should vary. I was gonna say, like, you know, I got, like, a handful of kingdoms for the elves and a handful of, like, different dwarven kingdoms. And it's like, for these lesser, like, gnomes and halflings and stuff like that, should they have, like, 2, 3, 4 different, like, variants? Or maybe just, like, have one... Maybe I should just do it based on the sub-races. What gear do we want to murder these guys in? I feel like I can do Sekai armor. Let's look at these tracks while he dies. So, that's the thing about that map creator, is you can only make, like, the images so big. And, like, if you try to, like, make the continents smaller so that you can fit more things in there, you start losing, like, definition on the models. Like, the textures of the stuff that you load in there. That thing's... It causes a real problem about, like, making a bigger map. The reality is actually since the last time we actually ran that campaign world...
Tracks lead to that homestead.
That map's tripled in size. But, the players start off on what I refer to as Central Midgard until they get the fog handled and then expand. So what I've been doing, because this is what people do with Incarnate, is you make the maps in chunks and then you stitch them together, like with paint or Photoshop or something like that.
Challenge me!
I get it, I lose it, man. I just... Give me that wind chime.
Please release me!
You're going to be all right.
Oh, thank you.
Your father told me about his choice to save you.
Save me? The Mongols asked him who to spare. My brother's name left his lips without a thought. When he saw they meant to kill Genta instead, he begged them to take me. I can't face him. This all happened because I asked Genta to help burn that wagon.
What do you want me to tell your father?
That you were too late to save me.
Damn. The dry country. So, like, you mean like countryside or like the actual, like I guess, nations. Because it's split up into four kingdoms still. Oh, the dry county. I get you. Yeah, that's just Ringsaker. That is just Ringsaker. It's the only place that's like that. That's part of the diversity, is that there's one place that can't get booze. Nuke it. Just kill it. Get it out of here. Yeah, I could... I think it's... I know how much there is now in the campaign. So I think we got enough countries. I think 4 countries in that main area for, like, the starting zone and, like, the first real quest of the world. I think it's a good starting point. And then knowing what I know about the way the rest of the world is, I think maybe I've got too much, maybe? I actually was dialing it back a chunk. Actually, there's like... Technically, there's like 6 countries on that first map. I feel like I need to add in more little towns. Like, should a map at that size only show like the big prominent towns and not the small villages, like just the cities?
Fight me!
Or should like every place where people live should be on the map? My legend grows. Oh, we hit it. The Ghost of Tsushima. Yeah, big cities, then you can freely add towns in, right? Yeah, that's what I was thinking. What's up, Glorious? Big cities, adding towns. What's up, Goat Slayer? At first, I didn't recognize that was a different name from my member. Yeah. Sticky bombs knock down all affected targets, leaving them vulnerable for... Yeah, I'm thinking about just leaving it as, like, the big, like, sizable living locations, like, decently sized settlements. Which, I gotta find that... There's a software out there or a website that helps you dictate like how much population a medieval city
Father's
should have
here. Maybe he left a clue where he went, a note. Guilt was too much. He drowned himself, but it was the Mongols who pushed him to it.
An enemy has a 15% chance to terrify nearby enemies. I mean, I guess it should, right? Like, I feel like my light's dimmed just now. I'm a little scared.
Huh?
Just in case we lose the stream out of nowhere. You guys know why. An enemy with a sticky bomb, huh? Switch to the tablet for comfy viewing. Nice.
Stand and fight!
Come out and fight me, nerd! Close to fair. Come on, man. Excuse me, sir. Okay, hold on. I got a funny idea. Get out of here. No, shit! Fuck! Get out of here! God damn it! I am the immortal! About as messy as it could humanly possibly be. And honestly, that's my favorite kind of combat. Like, we'll just let Fast Break derail this entire stream. Okay, I'm out. What do you mean pop in, drop 5 gift subs, and get out of here? And ooh, I recognize that Joker icon. I haven't seen that in a long time. Thank you so much, Fast Break Jake, for the 5 gifted subs. I don't know where that came from, but for a total of 71 subs in the channel, pure insanity. And I think Belly popped in here screaming, "I'm awake." Welcome, Belly. But thank you very much. Can we get some Vikings in chat for Fast Break and his great generosity as he leaves us right after he joins us? But the Realm Jack and Sights Took Two Scoops. I love that name. Coop de Jarnak and Rushman, thank you. And welcome to the Zixun Clan. Enjoy the emotes. There should be an achievement called King of the Hill for kicking that many people off the tower. I agree. I concur. I should be awarded a Medal of Honor for my heroic deeds in video gamedom. He just wanted that first place for the month. Did he just take it from you? There we go. I'm in. Why isn't it doing it? Thanks, I hate it. All right, blow up. So the algorithm for gifted subs, it's going to prioritize who's been here, who's viewed the most, then it goes to followers, and then it goes to networked viewers. So like, streams that we interact with a lot from our community, viewers in their channel start getting gift subs. But for us, it takes a long time for us to reach that point where it starts getting given to potentially random viewers, because we have over 1,700 followers. So basically, we would have to have like 1,700 subs before we would start giving out random subs to truly anybody on Twitch. Yeah, some of those names are probably off of our follow list.
Should destroy the seizure.
Oh, God damn it, I just want... Frustrating, man. I'm just trying to hold on to that ghost. You got blueberries? Blueberry jelly? Blueberry jelly blanket. I'm getting real excited to keep fleshing out our D&D world. We had a lot of fun getting community involvement and working on it. And... fuck your eagle.
Send your best warrior.
You sound like you're around a lot of fluffy things right now. A lot of very squishy, comfy objects. I recently got the wife one of those weighted blankets. Oh my god, she loves it. I thought it would help her sleep and like... because she happens to like just get random nightmares out of nowhere. a lot more than I get them, so I was hoping it would help her with that. And it doesn't help her with that so much as, like, just general anxiety when she's just, like, hanging out. Massively helps with that. Anytime she's feeling anxious, she just grabs the blanket and all is good in the hood. Here, have some rescue. Right in your face!
They almost killed me, my lord.
I know.
Thank you.
I was there.
Free. Find a safe place to hide.
There isn't one. The Mongols caught many of us at the crossroads nearby. They control the whole area.
Not for much longer. I'll see to it.
I don't know if I like the ninja, like, kind of want this. Oh, that's right. There's the Conqueror's Mask. Let's go with that one. That one's dope. Yeah, I'm excited for us to start working on it again. I got a bunch of ideas. We came up with some really cool stuff for the dwarves in our world. And the community helped a lot. Shrugs in particular. Shrugs and Lady Acorn gave a ton of help to that. We'll have to get Lady Acorn back in here when we start working on D&D again. She was a blast working on this stuff. What is this? Can I bow to it? This was a thing. This was a something. Forgot to kill a guy with a sticky bomb on that one mission. Too busy fucking kicking people off the top of a tower. You know, working on stuff. What are you talking about? We didn't lose anything, did we? I thought we were really far ahead. Oh, the rep thing. What a bunch of bullshit. Well, you know what though? It's still kind of a nice boost because I still have like over half of the bar from revered to exalted to go. And, you know, I leveled up a little bit of a Kul'tiran, so, you know, the rep grind we did on my paladin back then was worth it, because I've actually made use of it so far, but... Yeah, I'll just wait for the pre-patch. I'll go and do, what I gotta do. Oh, actually, hold on, guys. Let's take our first quick break here. I'm getting a call that I need to take. I'll be right back, all right?